welcome to Sesame Street. Today is my day off. The fix-it shop is closed. Luis is taking care of Gabriella, so I told Ruby I'd help her with an experiment.
Hi, Ruby.
Well, I'm here to help. What's the experiment?
Well, I haven't been able to think of one yet.
Oh, Ruby, when you asked me to help, I thought you already knew what you wanted to do.
I didn't. But I'll think of something. I always do.
Hi, Mike.
Oh, hi, Mike.
Hi, Billy. Hi, Ruby.
Wait a minute. How'd you know it was us? I mean, you're blind, right, Mike? And that means you can't see. And if you can't see, how did you know it was us?
I can hear you. My eyes don't work, but my ears do. And I know Maria's voice and your voice. So I knew it was you by listening to you talk.
See, listening is one way that blind people find out about things, Ruby.
Oh! What's another way?
By touching and feeling things with our hands. You mind if I touch your face so I can feel what you look like?
Oh, sure. Go right ahead, Mike.
I feel you have a lot of long, soft fur on your head.
Mm-hmm.
And your face is covered with soft, short fur.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, I better be going. I've got to get to Hooper's store.
Oh, wait a minute, Mike. Well, how are you going to do that? I mean, if you can't see, how do you know where you're going?
I know the neighborhood very well. And my dog, Duke, here, helps me get wherever I want to go.
That's a guide dog, Ruby. A lot of blind people have them.
So long.
See you later, Mike.
Bye-bye. Bye, Mike. I just got an idea for another experiment.
Here's a number that's mighty fun. We call this number number 9. So here's a puzzle that's got that plus. Turn it into nine red hearts. Nine bright shapes go fluttering by. Nine birds flying in the sky. Nine houses down on the street, dancing to this funky beat. Nine windows open wide. If you look inside, nine fingers if you hold back one. So here's my words and the song is done. That's nine things that nine can do. Now I'm done rapping, how about you? Nine.
And now it's time for your favorite show, On Vacation with Guy Smiley. America's most beloved game show host, Guy Smiley, and I'm here on vacation in the jungle. Yes. Where I am going to take pictures of the animals.
Mr. Smiley, you're talking too loud. Yes, come, we'll hide over here. The animals will be here in a moment.
All right, Mr. Guide, I'm right with you.
You're talking too loud. You'll scare all the animals away. Talk quietly like I am.
You mean like this?
No. Like this, quietly. Shh. Oh, I think there's an animal coming. Oh. Why, yes, it's a rabbit.
Yes, I think you're absolutely correct because it has long ears, it has whiskers, it has a curly tail, and it is a rabbit. Wait a minute, why did it run away? I wanted to take its picture.
It ran away because you talked too loud. You scared it. Next time, talk quietly.
You mean like this?
No, that's loud. Quieter.
Well, this is as quiet as I ever talk.
Shh, there's something coming.
Oh.
Yes, why, it's a monkey.
Yes, I think you're correct again because it looks like a little hairy person and it has a long curly tail and I think it must be, yes, it is a monkey! Oh, guide, why do the animals run away when I want to take their picture?
Because you're talking too loud.
Why didn't you say so?
I did. Now, here comes another animal. So talk quietly like me. Oh no! Why, it's...
Look at that! It looks like a big yellow kitty cat with black stripes. I think it must be, yes, it is a tiger!
I'm getting out of here!
And it roars! It is definitely a tiger!
Say, aren't you America's most beloved game show host, Guy Smiley?
That's right. I am America's most beloved game show host, Guy Smiley, and I'm here to take your picture.
Oh, I loved you in What's My Part, and Here's Your Life. Oh, how about a picture of us together?
That's a great idea. Oh, Guy, now where did he go?
Oh, maybe I roared too loud and scared him away. Give me that camera.
Wow.
I'll take a picture of you, then you can take a picture of me.
That's a great idea. I'm posing.
Wow, Guy Smiley.
Say trees.
Trees.
Tune in again for On Vacation with Guy Smiley. Mr. Smiley's Hat by Zimbabwe after 6.
Wash your face and hands.
My hands. My face.
Don't forget your ears.
Ah, my ears.
Did you brush your teeth?
Ah! My teeth.
Your teeth.
Now then, my teeth.
How is that, Ruby?
That's perfect, Maria. I can't see anything. Now I'm going to find out what it's like to be blind. Gee, everything's dark, Maria. I really can't see anything. Maria, are you still there?
Yes, I'm still here.
Hey, I can hear you.
Well, that's one way that a blind person finds out about things, by listening, remember?
Yeah, now I remember. Now I'm ready to do my experiment.
Okay, what is the question?
Can I get to the back of Hooper's store without being able to see, just like Mike did? I saw that even though Mike is blind and can't see anything, he was still able to get there. So, I'm gonna try this.
Well, that's a very good experiment, Ruby, but I'm not too sure about your planning. You see, and planning is a very important part of doing an experiment.
Yes, I did plan. The blindfold is on, Maria, so I can't see. Now, I just have to walk to Hooper's store.
But you don't have a guide dog like Mike does to help you get there.
Oh.
right. Now, if we had a little wind... Kay.
Oh, it's no use. I can't fall asleep. And you know why? It's because I miss my old buddy Bert. He's not here. See, he went to this pigeon festival. You know, with Bernice the pigeon? You know, it might make me feel better if I could tell you about it. I hope you don't mind listening. When Bert's not here, the hours last forever. The toys aren't fun and the cookies don't crunch. When Bert's not here, I don't feel so clever and I never even feel like having lunch. When Bert's not here, the place is too quiet. The windows creak, funny thoughts fill my head. When Bert's not here, no way to deny it. I feel I really should have stayed in bed. There's some peculiar things about him. What he likes and does can be a mystery. But to spend a rainy day without him makes me realize how much he means to me. When Bert's not here, the sky is not so sunny. My life seems blue, and from my point of view, when Bert's not here, the jokes aren't so funny, and I wonder what on earth I'm gonna do. When Bert's not here to play with me and you.
Well, you know, I do feel better now. I guess sometimes it does help to tell somebody how you feel. So thanks for listening. Oh, I bet I can fall right asleep now. Oh, good night.
Dear Nana, how are you? I started school today. I like my teachers very much. Love, Debbie. Now I need a stamp. My dad works for the postal service, so I decided to find out how stamps are made. This is the Bureau of Engraving and Printing. The first step in making a stamp is the idea. The postal service has made many stamps about the idea of love. This is what an artist painted for the new love stamp. The design is made smaller and put on a metal plate. This is called engraving. Each plate has 200 pictures on it. The first thing that happens is there's a big white roll of paper. It has glue on one side, so if you lick it, it will stick. The paper goes into the machine that prints the stamps. This stamp has 5 colors. Each color gets put onto the paper separately. The first metal engraved plate is coated with red ink. It prints the red part of the stamp onto the paper. They stop the machine so you can see what the stamps look like. Here it goes. The machine goes very fast. The stamps go by so fast that they look like stripes. This special light lets us look at the stamps even though it's going very fast. The second metal plate is coated with blue ink. It prints the blue part of the stamp. Next, the yellow ink is on. They print the colors on top of each other. Red, blue, and yellow make a brown dog. The fourth plate adds the black outline. The fifth plate prints the color purple and prints the word love. Now we've printed this whole big roll. The stamps are almost finished. All the colors are on and you can see what it's going to look like. But how do you tear off just one stamp? You need those little holes that separate the stamps. This machine punches the little holes in the stamps. This cuts them into sheets. Now they're ready for us to buy. And for me to stick on my letter.
Used to look like?
Yeah! You did it, Ruby. We're here at the back of Hooper's store. Congratulations. Your experiment is over. You walked all the way down Sesame Street blindfolded. What do you mean, We're here. You made it.
Well, you say we're here, but how can I be sure?
Well, you can take off your blindfold and look for yourself.
I've got a better idea, Maria. I'm going to do another experiment.
Another experiment?
Yep. I'm going to find out if I can tell whether I'm at the back of Hooper's store with my blindfold on.
But I already told you we are.
I can't take your word for it, Maria. I have to find out for myself. But how am I going to find out? I can't see anything. Oh, dear. But I feel something.
Now, Ruby, do you remember how Mike found out about things even though he couldn't see them?
By touching and feeling with his hands?
Mm-hmm.
Now I know what my experiment is. Can I tell what something is by using my hands?
Mm-hmm.
Like this. Okay, I feel fur. And a long tail. And a lot of long fur. You're ticklish. I think I found your head. Yeah, that's your head, all right. And here's your mouth. Yep. Oh, what's this? I know who you are! Snuffy!
Oh, how did you know it was me?
By touching you.
Uh-huh.
Who else on Sesame Street is as big as you are with long fur and a tail and a snuffle?
My mommy?
Yes, but your mommy has a different hairdo. I would have felt her hair.
Oh.
No, it could only be you, Snuffy.
Congratulations, Ruby.
Wait, Maria. The experiment's not over. I know Snuffy's here, but still I have to figure out if I'm at the back of Hooper's store. Yep.
But Ruby, I told you we are.
Oh, what's this? What is this? Wait, don't tell me. This feels flat. Yep, it's very flat. It's thin and flat. There's space under it. And there's something that goes to the ground. It's long and skinny. Like a table leg. This is a table.
Yeah.
Yep.
So now do you know where you are?
Yes, I must be in the back of Hooper's store.
Yes,
that's
just like I told
you. The only place on Sesame Street with a table like this.
Yeah.
But I found out for myself, Maria. Yes, I proved that I could tell what something is by using my hands.
If your experiment is over now, I think it's time for Gina to bring me my spaghetti snack.
Oh, that reminds me. I'm hungry. Are you hungry, Maria?
Yes, actually, I'm hungry.
Great! Because I've got an idea for another experiment.
Another experiment? Mm-hmm.
And you can help me.
Well, I'd love to help. What can I do?
Well, you can get us lunch.
That's it?
Mm-hmm. Only don't tell me what it is. Oh, boy! Another experiment! Gosh, this could be the greatest day of my life!
You about word called information, right? Information. And information mean news or facts about something. And Tara going to help Cookie Monster. Now, today we're going to give you information about word cookie. Give me cookie, please. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Right in my hand. Oh, thank you. That cookie. And now me give you information about Cookie. And the information is, Cookie was delicious. Give me other cookie, please. Other cookie. Oh, thank you, thank you. Now me give you more information. Cookie was delicious and crunchy. Now give me a whole box, please. Whole box. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, thank you very much, Tara. Now, rest of information. Cookie was delicious, crunchy, and Cookie's gone. Ah, ha, ha. Thank you, Tara. Give me a hug. Oh, thank you.
Bad news. You say you want to make the swim team and you need our help? Well, hold on tight. Everything's gonna be all right. I'm Billy Joe Jive, super crime fighting ace. Me and my partner, Smart Susie Sunset, are on the case.
We caught up with Bad News Barton at the gym where he was trying out for the swim team.
Okay, Bad News. Get in there with the others. Let's see you do your stuff. Okay. On your mark, get set. You better try out for the wrestling team. Swimming isn't your style.
Bad news. I've got an idea which will help you make the team. What did you have for lunch this week?
Well, on Monday I had 10 candy bars, and on Tuesday I had 4 apple pies, and today I had 6 chocolate brownies, 3 candy bars, and 2 apple pies.
Now, bad news, you want to make the swim team, don't you?
Right.
And to make the team, you've got to lose some blubber. Right?
Right.
Apple pies, candy bars, and brownies are no way to lose blubber. What you've got to do is change your eating habits. You have to eat more fruit, nuts, and vegetables, as well as milk and meat.
You know, Sunset, we haven't seen Bad News for 3 weeks. I wonder how he's doing with his new diet.
Isn't that Bad News coming down the street?
This apple sure is good. Hey, I made the swim team. And look, no more candy bars, brownies, and apple pies.
Well, another case wrapped up by the great team of Sunset and Jive.
Three. Five. One. Plus two. Makes three. Three. Plus two. Makes five.
Well, Ruby, now what?
Huh? Oh, I don't know. I can't think of anything.
I just got a great idea for an experiment.
What?
Well, do you hear that?
Yes, I hear it, but so what? What's the experiment?
Well, that's the experiment. Can you tell what somebody is doing by listening?
I bet I can. That's a great experiment. Gee, Maria, you're good at science.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah. Okay, now, I'm going to be very quiet so I can really listen. Okay. That sound is music, isn't it, Maria?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. It is music, but can you tell what's making that sound?
I'll listen some more. It sounds like a piano! Yeah. Do you think it's a piano?
Sounds like a piano to me.
You know what else, Maria?
What?
By listening so carefully, I can tell the sound of the piano is coming from up there!
Yeah, I think it's coming from Bob's apartment, too.
You do? Do you think Bob's playing the piano?
Oh, well, I don't know, Ruby. I can't see up there either.
Listen, listen, Maria. There's another sound. That's music, too, isn't it?
Yeah. I think so, but I'm not sure what's making it.
It sounds like some kind of horn to me.
Maybe that's it. Maybe Bob is giving a music lesson to someone who is playing a horn.
Yeah, hey, let's find out. Bob!
Oh, no, Ruby, oh, no, son. He's in the middle of a lesson.
Hey, Ruby, what's up?
Bob, I'm doing an experiment to find out if I can tell what something is by listening to it.
Ah, what'd you find out so far, Ruby?
That you were playing the piano.
Right.
And giving a music lesson?
Right again.
To somebody playing a horn?
Almost right, Hugh, Ruby.
I hear now to a lot of people playing horns.
No, Ruby. These guys play their noses.
We look alike.
We look alike.
We are the same.
We are the same.
It is our biggest claim to fame.
We look alike.
We look alike.
We are the same.
We are the same.
And the things alike. You
things with deference.
Oh, boy. Yeah, it's time for my nap. Oh, my tongue. Ah! Hey, Bert! Hey, Bert! Hey, buddy, Bert! Hey, Bert! Bert, where are you, Bert? Oh! You know, it is just possible that my old buddy Bert here is asleep. For one thing, he's lying down, which he usually does when he is asleep. For another thing, his eyes are closed. And for another thing, he's not answering me when I talk. Old buddy Bert is probably asleep, but I will check just to make sure. Poke, 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 poke. Note how I can poke old buddy Bert in the stomach and he doesn't complain. Now, when old buddy Bert is awake and I poke him in the stomach, he complains. Oh, looky here. Note how floppy and soggy-like old buddy Bert's arm is. Yeah. When old buddy Bert is awake, he's not floppy and soggy-like. So, I am quite certain that old buddy Bert is very definitely asleep. On the other hand, now his eyes are open. My old buddy Bert's eyes are usually open only when he is awake, so he's probably awake, but I will check just to make sure. Poop, 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 poop.
Now cut that out!
See, I was right. He's awake.
Ernie.
Yeah?
Why did you wake me up?
Did I wake you up, old buddy?
Yes, you did.
See? I was right. First he was asleep, now he is awake.
Ernie, why'd you wake me up?
Let's see, because I have something very important to tell you.
What's that?
Well, you see, I just looked at the clock.
So?
It's time for your nap.
I live in the city with my two brothers, Ben and Dave. And we have a lot of chores to do around the house. We feed the dog. I feed the fish. And we go shopping, go and get the things, and put them in the cart.
In the cart, Ann. Good boy. Come on. Yeah. What a good helper.
A chore is something you do to help your mom and dad out.
Terrific, Honkers. Now we're going to put them all together again, and we're going to play the scale, okay? Now, the scale sounds like this. Okay, now let me play it very slowly, and we'll do it all together, okay? Here we go. Terrific, Honkers. Now, you want to do it a little bit faster? Okay, here we go. Ready? Hey, that's really, really good. That's wonderful. All right, now let's do it even faster, okay? Ready? Okay, so far, so good. Here we go. Great, that's really wonderful. Now, shall we try it really, really fast? Okay, listen once. I'll play it really fast for you. Pretty fast. Want to try it? Okay, it's all yours. No. Hold it, honkers. That's not the scale. You're honking very, very fast, but you're not playing the scale. Listen to it again. Okay, try it again. No, that's still not the scale. You're just honking very, very fast, but you're not playing the scale. Let's play it slowly together once again, okay? Ready? Okay, here we go, slow. Okay, now I'm going to play it fast once and then see if you can play it fast. Ready? Here we go. Just listen to me first. Okay, now that's a fast scale. Try and do it again. No, hold it. That's still not the scale. You're just honking very fast, but you're not playing the scale. You know, honkers, I guess you can honk very fast, but you just can't play the scale very fast. I guess you just can't do both of them at the same time. Not yet. Honkers, no, don't cry. Honkers, come on, don't cry, guys. Come on. It's very, very simple. Wait a minute, don't you remember that song I taught you? Practice, do it again, over and over till you get it. Do you remember that? That's all you have to do. We just have to keep practicing a little more. Okay? Shall we try it again? Okay. We won't do it so fast this time. Just a little bit fast. Here we go. Good. Terrific.
Like the hoodoo, listen to the music so nicely organ played. quietly rests the sleepy tiger under the vine tree at the waterside, and X marks the place neath the yellow moon where the Tsumuchi and I did hide.
Umnandi, Umnandi, where love you to
up for the big race of the day. Over there we have number one, then numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. They're on their marks. They're set. They're off. A very fast start. Number three has jumped into the lead, followed closely by 2 and 1. As they round the first turn, 4 is going ahead of 3. Uh-oh, here comes 5, making his bid and forging into the lead. Rounding the final turn and coming toward the finish line, it's going to be a photo finish. The judge is now taking the winning number. He's walking down the line of weary contestants, ready to award the winner's wreath to the one carrying the matching number. And the winner, number 9.
Hey, all right, that's terrific, Honkers. That's wonderful. That's much, much better. You're playing the scale a lot faster. Wonderful. You know something? I'm very, very proud of you. Are you proud of yourselves, too? Well, you should be, because you worked very, very hard. That's great. You really did some good practicing. Listen, would you like to play something just for fun now? Would you? Okay. Here we go.
Do your experiment.
Okay. Thanks, Maria. Now, here's the question. Can I tell what's written on this piece of paper without seeing it? Now, it feels like a piece of paper, but I can't tell what's written on it. I don't smell anything. I don't hear anything either. Gee, I don't know how I'm going to be able to tell what's written here, Maria.
Hi, Mike. Ruby's doing an experiment.
Yeah. Oh, dear. Mike, maybe you can help me. How can you tell what's written on a piece of paper without being able to see it?
Well, one of the ways is by asking somebody to read it to me.
Oh, of course. Maria, could you read it to us?
Of course. Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters K and R, and by the number 9.